So, in this video, we are going to test our Primzjarnik-Lazy implementation. So I'm going to create a main method. Then I'm going to create a list for the vertices with the name vertexList is equal to a new ArrayList. I'm going to import the java.util.list. So I'm going to create the distinct vertices. The vertex 0 is equal to a new vertex with the name A, for example. I'm going to create 3 vertices just to be sure that our algorithm is working fine, and feel free to test the algorithm on much greater graphs as well. So I'm going to add the vertices to the vertex list. So add the vertex 0. Then the vertex 1 and then the vertex 2. Then I'm going to add several edges. So the vertex 0.addEdge, and I'm going to insert a new edge from vertex 0 to vertex 1, and the weight will be 1. Then I'm going to copy and paste it. Okay, then vertex 0. We add another edge from vertex 0 to vertex 2 with the edge weight 1, and then from vertex 1 to vertex 2 with edge weight 10. And basically, if we would like to make or simulate undirected edges, we have to do the same. So I'm going to add some edges to the 1 and then vertex 2, vertex 2. From the vertex 1 to vertex 0 with edge weight 1. What does it mean? Because we would like to simulate undirected edges, we are going to give an edge from vertex 0 to vertex 1, and then from vertex 1 to vertex 0. Basically, because there's a forward edge and there's a backward edge with the same edge weight, it is like we making undirected edges. And basically, we are going to add to the vertex 2 a new edge from vertex 2 to vertex 0 with the edge weight 1. And then we add to the vertex 2 a new edge from vertex 2 to vertex 1. So basically, this is how we simulate undirected edges, that we use directed edges, but we keep one forward edge, so from 0 to 1, and then from 1 to 0 with the same edge weight. I'm not sure whether it's clear, but in order to simulate undirected edges in the graph, we have to use something like this. Okay, then I'm going to instantiate the algorithm. A new algorithm, we have to specify the vertex list, because at the beginning, it's going to be the unvisited list. So the unvisited list is going to be the same as the vertex list. Okay, and then I'm going to run the Prim's algorithm, for example, from vertex 2. And then we have to show the minimum spanning tree. So we start at the vertex 2 and we would like to find the minimum spanning tree. Okay, there's a minimum spanning tree with cost 2 because we have to include the CA edge, so the edge between the vertex C and vertex A. Why? Because there's the edge weight is 1. Then we have to include the edge between vertex 0 and vertex 2. Basically, it is the CA, and the AB is going to be this edge. So basically, it is going to be the minimum spanning tree. What if, for example, I update it, and for example, I make the 1, 2 edge? What does it mean that between B and C to be enormous, in the sense that it's going to be 10, it's going to be 1, but the edge between the 0 and the 2 is going to be great. What does it mean that from A to C it is very expensive to go? So the AB is not going to be part of the minimum spanning tree. And yeah, it's not going to be part of the minimum spanning tree. If I set, for example, the edge weight to be equal to 100, then of course the total cost will be 11. And yeah, And of course we missed the 0, 1. What does it mean that the AB cost? And the AB is missing from the minimum spending tree. So basically, the lazy implementation of the Prim-Zionic algorithm is working fine. So what does it mean? It means that we have to keep track of an unvisited vertices, and the algorithm is going to iterate until the unvisited vertices is not empty. Then we consider all the neighbors of the given vertex. We have a starting vertex. We have to define it as we have discussed in the theoretical section. And basically, if we haven't visited this vertex so far, then we have to add this edge to the heap. So that's why we have to check whether the unvisited vertices contains the target vertex. After adding all the edges to the heap, then we are going to get the edge with the minimum edge weight. We add it to the spending tree, and basically we are going to update the vertex to be the get target vertex. We remove the vertex from the unvisited vertex, and basically this while loop is going to start again. So that's why it is the lazy implementation, because as you can see, we haven't changed the content of the edge heap. We haven't updated with the updated edge weight values because we have found the shortest path of the minimum spending tree and so on. Because this is the lazy implementation. In the eager implementation, we have to track whether, okay, are there any better solutions to the minimum spending tree, a shorter path, for example, that we have considered so far, and if there is, of course, we have to update the content of the heap. But because we check whether we have already considered that given edge in order to avoid cycles in the minimum spending tree, we can do that we insert everything to the edge heap without modifying its content. Because with the help of this if, we can make sure that there will be no cycles in the minimum spending tree, and basically it is very, very important. Thanks for watching.